Blackstone Audio presents Someone Always Knows by Marcia Muller. This book is read by Laura Hicks. For Bill, with love. Monday, October 5th. 11:12 a.m. It's awfully different from the artist's rendering, I whispered to my nephew Mick Savage. He and I and several of my staff were standing at the spacious entrance to the recently remodeled McCone and Rapinski building on New Montgomery Street in San Francisco's financial district. Workmen had just removed the tarps from a sculpture we'd commissioned, at great cost, from the world-renowned artist Flavio St. John. What do you suppose Flavio's intention was? Julia Raphael had recently been dating a prominent Latino painter and was into all things artistic.
He needed a cure for a hangover, Patrick Nealon offered, scratching at his thatch of red hair.
Don't be facetious, I said. What is it supposed to be?
Looks like clamshells. This from our office manager, Ted Smalley. A cheap concrete clamshell fused to a larger, fake gold one. Flavio must have been hungry for seafood the day he came up with the design. The workmen with the tarps seemed anxious to pack up and go. A small crowd had gathered, blocking their trucks.
Where is Flavio? I asked.
Rome, Patrick said. He had urgent business there, so I drove him to the airport the other night.
Urgent business? Without letting me know he was leaving?
More likely he was escaping the scene of the crime with our check in his wallet. I'm putting a stop on it. Ma'am, a gentleman in the growing crowd said, can you explain why you people elected to put such an eyesore on your beautifully restored granite building?
Well, I began, we thought the concept is
As ugly as my Aunt Stella Sue's butt.
That came from my husband, standing on the edge of the crowd. Tall, lean in his tight jeans, with the brim of his cowboy hat pulled down over his roughly hewn face. People erupted into laughter at his remark. Trying not to laugh myself, I said, the gentleman who just spoke is my partner and co-owner of the building, so I suppose he has a right to express his opinion. I shot high a dark look and added, and you don't have an Aunt Stella Sue. He shrugged. You may as well come up here and say a few words. He shouldered through the crowd.
Actually, folks, I was just joking. The designer of this dramatic entrance, Flavio St. John, is one of the finest sculptors in the world. His talents in any form of sculpting surpass even those of the late Beniamino Buffano, who, except for that horror of a spire that looks like a totem pole at Timber Cove Inn up the coast, did all of us Californians proud.
I stepped on High's foot, hard. He added,
apparently our clamshells are Flavio's equivalent of Buffano's totem pole.
Then, mercifully, he shut up.
Thanks for coming, I called to the crowd and turned to glare at High. He backed up, holding his hands out defensively. What could I say? It's a piece of shit.
Of course it is.
I took his arm and hustled him toward the door. We ought to sue that rat-faced little bastard, he added.
Keep your voice down.
Crappy concrete and bogus gold that look like clamshells with chipped edges are not the way to inaugurate our new partnership.
We'll do something about it.
What? There's probably some goddamn clause in our contract with him that says we can't alter it without his permission.
Then it'll just have to meet with an accident. A terrible accident.
McCone, I love the way you think, he said.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.